Hi everyone, happy Wednesday. We've made it to the middle of the week. That's so exciting. I love this time. So what I'm here to talk to you about today is the single biggest reason why diets don't work. We hear the term diet and immediately a red flag goes up in our brain. And our brain says, not doing this, we're out. Like, who can relate to that? Or you hear diet and you go, okay, which one are you following? Are you following Whole30? Are you following Paleo? Are you eating more of a plant-based diet? Are you, you know, doing whatever it is? There are so many out there. Are you on a calorie restriction diet? And as someone pointed out to me, we're all on a diet, which is true. We all are on a diet. It's all about what we choose to put in our bodies. And it could be I make up my food intake between graham crackers and Tostitos, and that's my diet. But that's probably not the healthiest option to fuel my body. So the biggest reason why diets don't work is diets are restrictive, and they make a controlling relationship between food and you and you and food. So when I was in the middle of my weight loss journey, whenever that was back a few years ago, I was following a calorie restricting diet. So 1500 to 1700 calories a day. And if I was going to go over that, of course, I needed to increase my exercise for that day or for that week to create a deficit, to see weight loss. It worked. I logged my food. I did that every day and I became a chain to logging my food, but it also created a restrictive relationship between food and myself. I found those foods that I could put in my body, track them, meet my target goals, still satisfy me, but weren't always the best for me. My nutritionist and I also had conversations about switching my coffee, my one cup of coffee, with a tablespoon of Natural Bliss creamer over to a dry powdered version of like International Delight or anything like that, and drinking that in the morning. So I was trading coffee, so coffee beans, and my creamer that had like four ingredients in it or less for something that was chemically laden. It may look better number calorically wise, but it didn't mean it was a good thing for me. And then I just started feeling like I was restricted by this and I wasn't allowed to have anything that didn't help me get to that caloric number. And I got very frustrated with keeping track of my food as well. And so I stopped doing that. And then I did fairly well going off the grid in 2018 and just kind of freestyling myself because I had done it for so long. So it was a pattern that was ingrained in my head. From January of 2017 until September of 2017, I released 47 pounds. My goal was 50. I made 47. And then I had a plateau and I wouldn't go up above 3 pounds and I wouldn't lose any more than 3 pounds. And I kind of stayed at that weight. And I truly believe it's because I was restricted in what I was eating. I wasn't causing my body to challenge itself to break down other nutrients. And so some people stop following, just like I said, stop following the diet altogether. Now, I stuck with it for an extended period of time, but most people give up within the first 15 days, sometimes 10, because they feel so restricted. And what we do for our nutrition can translate over into our finances and our family and how we show up in different areas of our life. And I know that if I am not taking care of my physical fitness and eating well, it trickles over into my finances and eventually starts to affect my family, not only from a financial standpoint, but because I'm not capable of doing the things that I want to do, like sit in a ride at a fair or sit in an auditorium chair or attend a concert, because let's face it, those chairs are really, they're really hard to fit into when you're 300 plus pounds. And I watched myself gain that weight back over the course of 2019, and then I kind of stayed there in 2020, but it slowly started creeping up, even though I was exercising during the summer, but I still wasn't feeding myself good food all the time. And I was definitely not eating in a manner that would allow me to release weight. And I knew I had to change my relationship with food. It wasn't about all the foods I was eating, it was how I was eating them and what I was putting in my body, along with the other things that might be causing issues. Like for me, it could be gluten, it could be sugar, any of those things. But I'm getting off on a tangent and I don't want to do that to you because I want this to be informational. So the single biggest reason why diets don't work is diets are restrictive and controlling the relationship between you and food and food and you. So once you work on that relationship between you and food and you, because how many of us celebrate birthdays and anniversaries and special occasions with sweet treats and, you know, tons of caloric food, like food that's really high in fat and calories? We celebrate that way. What if there's a different alternative? And that's what I'm learning about. I'm learning about creating a life that food and I have a relationship. Like I think about the food as I'm cutting it up to add it to my, you know, my dish. I'm thinking about where was it grown? How was it grown? Where did it come from? What part of, you know, the United States or wherever did it come from? I'm thinking about all those things. I'm thinking about how as I'm eating it, it's going to nourish my body and satisfy me and make me feel full. So if you're feeling that way, in the coming months, we are going to be talking about diets, but we're going to talk about nutrition and helping ourselves have this really good relationship with food over in my Balanced and Successful Working Moms group. And I invite you to join us over there. Again, it's on Facebook. I know not everyone likes Facebook, but there are good things on Facebook. You just have to look for them. And this is one of those places. So again, I invite you to join us over there. Currently in March, we're going to start a 30-day run to work on your debt and also to trade one thing that doesn't serve you for something that does. So we have those things going on in March, and then April and May we'll start